June 1st, 2016, I am continuing to document how the illegal aliens mafia kill American citizens after stealing their identities and government benefits. This is a paper, a release that Luisa Oyarzun was asked to fill out while she was being the victim of extortion by this supposed doctor's office called Honeo Falls Valley Family Practice, 23 Ontario Street, Honeo Falls, New York, 14472, phone number 585-624-2121. And the reason why she was given this form is because this form is to send her records to somebody else without her consent. Not to her, and this is what happens here. Luisa Oyarzun was taken by her caretaker to this doctor's office. The doctor asked her for her medical records, which she was carrying with her. She gave her copy of her medical records to this doctor's office, the staff there, and now the staff have kidnapped her medical records and is practicing extortion on elderly disabled citizen Luisa Oyarzun. They want her to send this release to them so they can send her medical records to somebody else, and they can just, with her signature there, they can just fill out the spaces below right here where she crossed it out and send it to any doctors they want. This is trafficking of medical records, and the reason why they need this medical record is because a lot of illegal aliens in the country are using Luisa Oyarzun's social security number and identity. Why? Because they need her government benefits, her New York State pension, her medical insurance, New York State State Medicaid, and the medications and medical care that they get with her medical insurances, her medical insurance, which is New York State Straight Medicaid. And so they get free medical and health care courtesy of the taxpayers through stealing their social security numbers and the identities of different citizens, United States citizens, who worked dozens of years of their lives and paid taxes and contributed to the social security to end up old and sick and not get the medical care that they need, so because their medical insurances are being sold to illegals by doctor's offices and the Department of Social Services across the country, specifically the Westchester County Department of Social Services, which still, after 4 months that Luisa Oyarzun moved from there to Livingston County, has open cases with Luisa Oyarzun and is telling the taxpayers that she lives there in Westchester County. And the Department of Social Services here in Livingston County, where Luisa Oyarzun has been living since March 5th, 2016, and the Livingston County Department of Social Services is selling her Medicaid to illegals in the county and across the country too, because they go to other states and they can use the New York State Straight Medicaid belonging to Luisa Oyarzun. So this office, in other words, is violating the law. It is refusing to give back Luisa Oyarzun's medical file, which belongs to Luisa, and one. And number two, Luisa lent the medical file to them so they could make copies. Now they're saying, we're not going to give you back your medical file, and you have to do what we tell you to do to get your medical file back. So this is what has been happening right now. Let me call the doctor's office. Let's see what happens. Let's see.
The office is closed for the evening and will reopen tomorrow morning at 8:30. If you have an urgent medical concern, you can go to any urgent care or emergency room without a referral. If you need medical advice, please stay on the line for the office answering service. The number for the answering service is 258-4831. Thank you.
the office is now closed. Normal business hours are Monday and Wednesday from 8:30 a.m. till 8 p.m. and Tuesday, Thursday, Friday from 8:30 a.m. until 4:30 p.m. with lunch taken daily from 12:30 to 1:30. Saturdays, the office is open from 8:30 until 12 noon. If this is a true medical emergency, press 0 now to speak with an operator.
Please wait while I connect you. Good afternoon, Honeywell Family Practice Answering Service. Hello.
Good afternoon, this is Professor Solange Martinez. I'm calling regarding elderly and chronically ill cancer dying patient Luisa Oyarzun, who was going to be seen at the Honeywell Falls medical practice, but...
Hello?
Hello?
I'm having trouble hearing you. I'm kind of muffled.
Okay.
I'm having trouble hearing you.
Can you hear me now?
Hello?
Hello?
No, you're really far away from the phone.
Oh, okay.
I can't hear you so well.
Okay, can you hear me now? Hello? Well, this is one of the characteristics of the illegal aliens mafia victims. Their phone lines are either cut off or illegally intersected, so they cannot run an errand or communicate with anybody. And it makes it really difficult for them to get in contact with anybody. So let's try something else.
Thank you for calling. This is Ellie Kimley. The office is now closed. Normal.
Sure.
Service.
Good afternoon. This is Professor Solange Martinez. I'm calling because of Luisa Oyarzun's petition. She asked me to call and ask to please have her medical file forwarded to her, which was stolen and now is being kept hostage by Honeywell Falls Medical Practice. She never saw any doctors there, and they refused to see her. Nevertheless, they are kidnapping her medical records. Okay, because Luisa Oyarzun is an elderly and chronically ill cancer-dying patient, and she cannot see any other doctor because she doesn't have her medical file, which was kept illegally by Honeywell Falls medical practice, family practice, and she needs her medical file back. So now they are practicing extortion on her and telling her that she needs to sign a release to get the medical file that she handed to them, so they could make copies of it and give it back to her. Now they don't want to give it back to her, and she never saw a doctor there. So what they're doing is illegal. They're not supposed to steal the prospective patient's medical file. They're supposed to give them back their file if they're not going to be seen at the doctor's office. No, what I'm saying is for you to give them a message that what they're doing is illegal, and they know it's illegal. They sent her a release form to get the medical file that she handed to them because they made her believe that she was going to be seen there, but in reality, they didn't have any intentions of seeing her there because they gave her an appointment and they canceled that appointment. And now they're refusing to see her. Or they're giving her an appointment like a month or in August or a month from now, and she cannot wait. She's dying of cancer.
Okay.
Yes, I have an elderly and chronically ill citizen who is dying of cancer who needs her medical file, which she handed to the practice when they made her believe that she was going to be seen by one of their doctors. But they declined to see her, and now she needs her medical file, the one that she gave them, to see another doctor. Excuse me? Yes, I just don't want to speak to them because they are refusing to give her her medical file. I was wondering if I could speak to the CEO of the clinic or this medical practice, because what they are doing is illegal. They're not supposed to kidnap the prospective patient's medical file.
Can I help you? We are a telephone answering service for medical emergencies.
Yes.
Tomorrow you'll need to call back on Tuesday.
Okay. Well, I guess I should tell you that Luisa Yasin cannot see any doctor, and she needs her medical file to see a doctor. So I don't know what else to do, because she needs medication, and the doctor needs to prescribe the medication.
Are you still a patient in this office?
No, she was never a patient of that office. The office made her believe that they were going to see her as a patient, and then they told her that they were not going to see her. And now they kept her medical file, which she gave to them. She has never been a patient in that office. I'm sorry? Yes, I took her to the to an urgent care facility, but they are going to see her for an urgent care situation, and she needs to see a doctor to get the prescription that she needs.
Okay.
She's dying of cancer. She needs about 15 prescriptions. Okay. Okay, and this is, as you have seen, the illegal aliens mafia persecution and control, total control of their victims after they steal their identities and government benefits. They steal the victims' homes, the victims' medical insurances, the victims' medical file, which is illegal, of course. And all the victims can get is, we cannot see you, call back another day, and so on. And Luisa Oyarzun, which is a sample case, Luisa Oyarzun's case is one in millions. And I'm trying to document everything that USA citizens go through when the illegal mafia go after them after they sell their identities and identities and government benefits to illegals in the country. And the ones that sell these are the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services around the across the country, specifically the one in Jamaica, New York, the Social Security Administration offices around the country, and specifically the one in Yonkers, New York, on South Broadway, which still has Luisa Oyarzun's records, even though she has not lived there since 4 months ago when she moved to another county about 8 hours away from Westchester County, or 8 hours away from there. And also the Department of Social Services across the country, specifically Westchester County and Livingston County, which have been falsifying records and selling the citizens' identities that come across their desks to illegals in the country, as well as the citizens' government benefits, Medicaid, New York State Straight Medicaid, food stamps, gas and electricity assistance, you name it. And this is all courtesy of the taxpayers who have to pay for these services. For citizens who, after working and paying taxes for dozens of years of their lives, like Luisa Oyarzun, end up with nothing, even their medical records, because it is stolen by the Department of Social Services employees or by the clinics or doctors who are illegal aliens mafia members who get paid with the taxpayers to falsify documents and to continue the trafficking of government benefits, and citizens' identities. Again, today is July 1st, 2016.